Hello and welcome to this edition of Phi TV. I'm your host, Brad Swanson. We are here just a few blocks from Florida's capital during what is this crazy pandemic of COVID-19 affecting Florida's economy. Today, I'm joined by Ken Armstrong, who's president and CEO of the Florida Trucking Association. And Ken is chairing the Transportation and Infrastructure Working Group for Associated Industries Reset Task Force effort. The RESET stands for Restore Economic Strength Through Employment and Tourism. Ken, thanks for coming on.
My pleasure.
All right. So you've been in the middle of one of more than a few task forces that AIF is working on. But before we get to that, let's talk about your industry. How have you seen your industry, the trucking industry, change as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic?
Well, our industry is not monolithic. Our industry is very broad, very diverse. Mm-hmm. So 82% of our industry has done really well, been very busy, sort of been the heroes of this process.
All the supply, yeah.
On the other hand, if you hauled cars, you know, you've been dry.
Right,
business
right.
has been way down. But right. by and large, our industry has been really necessary, has right. responded really well, and our image probably as sort of heroes and
sure.
sort of first responders is really strong.
It's definitely been evident in your publications that you've been pushing out. It's an interesting take, unless you're a transportation nerd like myself and a former DOTer, right?
Yes, indeed.
You don't. The average American doesn't think of freight. They just hope it's on the shelves. But you think of the runs we've had on certain supplies and things like that. It's been the guys and the men and women in your industry that are working 24/7. What specific measures are the trucking industry taking? Like when I think of roads, I think of like checkpoints and things like that. Any impacts, at least in Florida's infrastructure, that has helped or challenged the trucking industry to find new solutions?
Oh, I'd say by and large, the waivers, the exemptions, mm-hmm. most of which use the term essential.
Right.
You know, if you're essential, you bypass this checkpoint. If you're essential, you have an hours of service waiver.
Yeah. Yeah.
So by and large, government, local, state, national, has really gone out of their way to make sure the trucks are rolling.
Right. Okay.
And that there aren't obstacles. Yes, we had issues, you know, the Pennsylvania Turnpike Authority closed
sure.
rest areas for a while. So yes, that creates
a overall, the report card on Governor DeSantis and Secretary Tebow, all good, huh?
Yeah, I would say so.
That's great.
Our industry has appreciated their support.
Oh, that's amazing. Well, that's great to hear. All right, so let's get into the task force. So we know RESET has not released their recommendations to the governor yet, so we're not asking you to divulge any big reveals here. But talk to us about some of the kind of the top common themes that you're seeing across the industries
sure.
that deal with infrastructure. And this is everybody who turns a spade of dirt to build a road, to folks that build bridges, to trains, to planes, trains, and automobiles. So what are you seeing?
Well, fairly quickly, our working group said there are a few no-brainers mm-hmm. Because they're sort of business constants mm-hmm. or transportation constants. And I don't think I'm letting any cats out of the bag to say that COVID liability mm-hmm. is a big issue for the business industry and certainly transportation as well, because we're out there in contact with everybody.
Right.
The State Transportation Trust Fund mm-hmm. is really important to our industry, and we think to the people of Florida. So there are sort of some general business areas that were easy for us.
Sure. Well, I think those will be a no-brainer across the, mm-hmm. For the governor's office to take those types of recommendations, you know, tax and legal and structure and everything. But you think about that liability, that's going to just apply for everybody. All right, so we've got about 10-15 seconds to go here. Top thought for transportation and infrastructure going forward. What's the one nugget that you see as good for Florida?
I would say the collaboration with the federal government, mm-hmm. you know, what types of supports and plans and initiatives and funds can come to Florida We're in a unique position. We're a pivotal state in a lot of ways.
Right.
And so our working group felt it really, really important that we get on the same page with the feds and see what kind of dollars and support should be coming here.
Well, as a member of that working group, you did a great job leading it. I know we've got a little bit more work to
Thanks for your service on that work group.
Yeah, our pleasure. And thanks for all that you do for the trucking industry. We know Florida doesn't move without our trucks, and nor does anything that we buy or consume every day. So
your tomorrow is on a truck today.
I like it. That's a great tagline. Thank you, Ken, for coming on Fi TV. We appreciate you.
Thank you, Brad.
That's all the time we have for this episode of Fi TV. On behalf of our cable members and the 130,000 people in Florida that make it possible for you to connect to the internet or to your television, thanks for tuning in.